Hello friends, today we are going to see the developmental patterns of metazoa. The kingdom Animalia is divided into two groups, that is protozoa and metazoa. The protozoans include unicellular animals like paramecium, amoeba, etc. while metazoans include multicellular animals like sea anemones, earthworms, etc. Metazoans belongs to one of the following branches: diploblasts, protostomes and deuterostomes. Phylum Porifera include sponges that differ so much in their development from other animals, they are considered as parazoans rather than metazoans. Some of the unique developmental differences between sponges and other metazoans include: they are asymmetrical, they show presence of archaeocytes that gives rise to all other cell types, they show specific aggregation of cells to form new sponges, and there is an absence of mesoderm. First metazoan type is the diploblast. They have only two germ layers, that is endoderm and ectoderm. Mesoderm is either absent or rudimentary. They have radial symmetry, hence are included in radiata. Example is phylum Cnidaria or Coelenterata and phylum Ctenophora. All other remaining metazoans have three germ layers, hence are called triploblastic animals, and have bilateral symmetry, hence called bilaterians. Bilaterians are further divided into two groups, protostomes and deuterostomes. The name itself indicates the protostomes are the animals in which first opening gives rise to mouth, while deuterostomes, in which the deutero means second, stoma means mouth, the second opening gives rise to mouth. Protostome embryos undergoes chiral cleavage, that is, dividing cells are offset from each other, and determinate cleavage, that is, cell fate is precisely determined. Deuterostomes, on the other hand, show radial cleavage, that is, cells align with each other, and indeterminate cleavage, that is, cell fate is not precisely determined. The blastopore, which is the first opening formed as a result of gastrulation, gives rise to mouth in protostomes, while it gives rise to anus in deuterostomes. Phloem, fluid-filled cavity lined by mesoderm, it is caesocoelous in protostomes, meaning the cavity formed as a result of splitting of the mesoderm, while deuterostomes have enterocoelous cavity, means cavity formed as a result of outpocketing of gut that pinches off mesoderm. The skeleton of protostomes is derived from ectoderm, while deuterostome exoskeleton is derived from mesoderm. Protostomes show mosaic development, that is, morphogenic determinants are placed in different regions of the egg so that cell type is determined by them, while deuterostomes show regulative development, that is, morphogenic determinants are equally spaced in egg cytoplasm. Protostomes show autonomous specification, that is, cell fate does not change according to the surrounding conditions, while deuterostomes show conditional specification, that is, cell fate is determined by the condition in which cell finds itself. The examples of protostomes includes all the metazoans except Ambulacria and Chordata. While deuterostomes include Ambulacraria, that is, echinoderms and hemichordates, urochordata, cephalochordata and vertebrata.